Hello. Inside that glass bowl, she was pirouetting.
Oh, I don't often get to lie on water in
a landscape like this one. The draw. I open
Inside the cover. Shower caps, just sitting by the open window and the curtain was blown in St. Petersburg in the Hermitage. And you looked out of the window and there were all of these men and their outfits, their Cossack outfits, I guess. I couldn't believe it because she was only 13 when she lived in East Germany and went there then, and this was 2003 and it was exactly the same. Anyway, Catherine the Great, these two young girls at the place where I performed, and it was this giant, I'm telling you, there were like 10,000 people in there this weekend, and they were just going up and down the stairs into all these different little rooms, and two of the girls came up to me and they wanted to spend time with me, and there was also Pauline, who was an opera singer. And I got them all together and I said, Pauline, we must take these girls to Catherine the Great's palace, the summer palace outside of St. Petersburg. And she actually picked me up. And I don't even know how it was arranged, but suddenly these two 15-year-old girls were standing in the corner. They got in the car. We went to the palace. I couldn't believe it. I just had done a piece about Catherine the Great. Catherine the Great, 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 Catherine the Great. Catherine was known, you know, there's that whole myth about Catherine, but actually it's not really true. She liked to ride the horses, but that's all she did with them. She really only had seven lovers, Catherine the Great. I mean, she had this husband the first one. He was a little insane. He used to have battle plans on the royal bed, and he somehow used rats to play some of the characters. I mean, very strange guy. Of course she had to have some other lovers, like Rimsky-Korsakov, Potemkin. I mean, really, there were only seven. Think about it nowadays. Seven lovers? Is that a lot or a little? Okay, what did I say? I don't know. All right. Used rats, don't know if they were dead or not, but he didn't like to have sex. Yes, she had a son, but not sure it was his. One of the lovers was Rimsky-Korsakov, but not the composer, Potemkin. Maybe you can look it up after the gig to find out if she really was with Potemkin. Maybe right now I'll step into the music, and the whole horse thing was might myth, though she did like to ride, and she was an excellent administrator. Yes, she was. She cherished paperwork. Yes, paperwork and penises. Paperwork and penises! Well, that's another story. She brought French culture to Russia. Diderot was a friend. Catherine the Great. Oh, Catherine the Great. Oh, Catherine the Great. You talk about bringing them all together, right? Like, yeah. I mean, I don't know what to say. I was walking in Berlin the other day and I saw these two guys, and I could tell that they had accents that were not German. One of them was from Russia, and we started to talk about what was happening there with the rebel, with the rebels. And he had a totally different point of view. Different information, and can we ever know everything that's going on in the world? Yeah. We have ripped buttons.
Adios.